and thank you for joining me. Today I'm going to be making a soap, which is a multicoloured soap, rainbow soap. And I'm going to be calling it Pride. It's actually fragrance with Bite Me from Nature's Garden. And I'll take you through the colours shortly, so let's go! Right everybody, this is one of my go-to recipes. So the colours I'll be using today are Neon Mica from Mad Oils. I've got Yellow Iron Oxide powder, and that's from Just a Soap. And I've mixed that with Bonnie Buttercup Sparkle from YouMakeItUp.com. I've got Brilliant Blue Lake Powder, and that's from Just a Soap. I've got Poncho Red Lake Powder from Just a Soap. And that's how you spell it. It's P-O-N-C-E-A-U. I've got Virtuous Violet from YouMakeItUp.com. And Bejeweled Mica from YouMakeItUp.com. Now with the Red Lake powder from Just a Soap, I put a little bit of the cranberry red colourant from Just a Soap, which is in liquid form. So all the colours are ready, yellow. And also what I've done is in the green I mixed in some organic French green clay. So I'll probably do that with the red as well. So we're going to add some kaolin clay to the actual oils in their entirety. This is my kaolin clay, which also I purchased from YouMakeItUp.com. Because there's 5 pounds of oil in here, I would use 5 level tablespoons of kaolin clay to go into the oils. I use kaolin clay simply because it helps retain the scent in the actual cold process soap, and also it has lots of skin benefits as well. When I'm mixing my colorants, such as the Yellow Iron Oxide and the Bonnie Buttercup Sparkle, what I do is I put in some of the oils either from the main batch or just a little bit of olive oil to mix it up with. And I use one of these like coffee, I don't know what you call them, like a little whisk, I suppose, an electronic whisk, and obviously make sure that everything is well mixed. With the lake powders I've used less because it's more pigmented. So in here I've got the orange Neon Mica by Mad Oils, and I've used 1 teaspoon in here, whereas with the red, if it being a lake powder and being more pigmented, I've used about a quarter of a teaspoon and a couple of drops of the actual liquid colourant. Okay, I'll bring you back for adding the lye and everything. I'm just going to get this kaolin clay well mixed in to the actual oils, and I'll give you my recipe. This is a go-to recipe for me and I love it. So I'm using 497 grams of olive oil, 497 grams of palm oil, 447 grams of coconut oil, which is the 76 degree one. I used 248 grams of rice bran, or you can use 248 grams of rapeseed oil, or you can use 248 grams of almond oil, whichever you want, but obviously when you do that you've got to change the amount of lye, so make sure you put it through a soap calculator. So in this batch I've got 248 grams of rice bran, and then 99 grams of shea butter, and 24 grams of castor oil. I've got 689 grams of distilled water, and 255 grams of lye. Now if I was using the rapeseed, I would use the same amount of water, which is 689 grams of distilled water, and I'd use 253 grams of lye, just because obviously different oils have different saponification values, or known as sap values as well. Okay.